Assalamu alaikum. A warm greetings to all distinguished guests, honorable speaker, students, and dear audience. IEEE BUBT student branch is back with another webinar for our enthusiastic participants. This time, the webinar is on business analytics and digital marketing. I feel privileged to welcome you to the webinar. Thank you all for your precious time and attending today's webinar. Throughout the webinar, along with you, I am Tariq Ulissam Rimon, student of Department of IEEE, Bangladesh University of Business and Technology, and chair of IEEE Council on Superconductivity, BUBT Student Branch Chapter.
And this is Ramisa Anand, student of Department of CSC, BUBT, and chair of IEEE BUBT, Women in Engineering Student Branch Affinity Group. The webinar on Business Analytics and Digital Marketing is organized jointly by IEEE Sensor Council, IEEE Biometrics Council, IEEE NPSS-BUBT Student Branch Chapter, IEEE BUBT Women in Engineering Student Branch Affinity Group, and IEEE Council on Superconductivity BUBT Student Branch Chapter. At the initial stage of the webinar, I would like to request to present the introduction video of the IEEE BUBT Student Branch and its all chapters and councils.
Thank you. Business analytics, a data management solution, and business intelligence subset refers to the use of methodologies such as data mining, predictive analytics, and statistical analysis in order to analyze and transform data into useful information, identify and anticipate trends and outcomes, and ultimately make smarter data-driven business decisions. The main components of a typical business analytics dashboard include data aggregation, data mining, association, and sequence identification. Text mining, forecasting, predictive analytics, optimization, and last but not the least, data visualization.
Any marketing that uses electronic device to convey promotional messaging and measure its impact. In practice, digital marketing typically refer to marketing campaign that appear on a computer, phone, tablet, or other device. It can take many forms, including online video, display ads, and social media posts. Digital marketing is often compared to traditional marketing, such as magazine ads, billboards, and direct mail. Oddly, television is usually lumped in with traditional marketing. To optimize your marketing strategies, digital is mandatory. Digital marketing can help you to get to know your audience, learn important data about them, and provide metrics that will give you marketing team credibility.
Dear all participants, the time will rank to introduce with the honorable speaker of today's highlighted webinar. We are here with Sarthak Sengupta. He is a senior research scholar and teaching assistant. He is pursuing PhD at Indian Institute of Information Technology, Allahabad. He has completed his Bachelor of Engineering in Computer Science and Master's in Business Administration in Human Resources and Marketing Management. Prior to this, he has work experience in General Electric, Alstom, Rover PS1925, and IBM. He is also managing startups for research and strategic development. His research and teaching includes human resource management information systems, negotiation, conflict management, data mining, machine learning, economics, marketing management, optimization, and social media analytics. He has published 26 research papers in various conferences, book chapters, and journals of repute. He has worked in different parts of India, and this has helped him in becoming a highly adaptable individual.
He likes working in challenging environments, and this has helped him develop a dynamic personality with cross-cultural sensitivity. He had participated in Genesis, Japan East Asia Network of Exchange for Students and Youths. Economics Batch 2016, Japan. A people-to-people exchange program promoted and funded by the Japanese government to foster international cooperation and economic partnership. He is the recipient of the Young Scientist Award, American Finance Association Travel Grant Award, and 4 Best Paper Awards. He has a diploma in cyber law. He has qualified for GATE and CAT. He is a certified system security analyst and chairperson of IEEE student branch. His international exposure includes Malaysia, Japan, United States of America, China, Thailand.
Thank you. Now, I'd like to welcome our speaker once again and request him to start his demonstration.
Thank you so much for this wonderful opportunity. And I'm extremely obliged for this webinars being a speaker. And just, you know, I just keep the video off just to, you know, save the internet data for everyone, because I can understand after the entire days, you know, some might have some data issues. So obviously I'll keep my video on whenever I'm explaining with hand, else I'll just, you know, take the permission to keep the video off. Can I?
Yes, sir.
Thank you so much. So I'll be sharing my screen for my presentation. And even on Sunday, like, I'm really obliged to get such a wide audience. And I came to know that today's there is obviously a final also. So some people were busy with that also, World Cup final. So I'm really obliged that everyone is here still. And we got a huge participation thanks to the esteemed IEEE student branch. So basically, today I'll be discussing about the topic business analytics and digital marketing. So obviously, it's a very important topic. And the reason behind taking the two topics together is that, you know, suppose someone wants to understand management information systems, then that person has to know the aspects of management as well as IT. The same thing goes with business analytics and digital marketing. They are kind of two very good brothers who were always together and will be together just to grow more and more, right? So business analytics and digital marketing are nowadays one of the major aspects in the economy as well as the world, because today we can see, because of the COVID-19 pandemic, each and everything has went to the online scenario. We see everywhere the online pedagogy is being followed. Nowadays, even, you know, the kind of habit also, you know, because of this habit, we have, you know, whenever we try to buy something, nowadays, we don't go to the shops or shopping malls normally because of the things like, okay, come on, we have to wear a mask. We used to use sanitizers. Or come on, who is, like, we don't know what the shopkeeper is carrying, you know, COVID-19 or coronavirus. We don't know. So we prefer, you know, buying online. That is through Amazon, Flipkart, or, you know, Alibaba, or lots of websites are there. So we can understand how things have went to another atmosphere, that is the IT infrastructure based management. Okay, so here comes the game of business analytics and digital marketing. So basically, we can understand that business analytics is a data management solution, and it is a subset of business intelligence. Okay, so like, subset and superset. I can just, you know, in simple language I can tell you is that if suppose a superset is artificial intelligence, then its subset is machine learning, and the subset of machine learning is deep learning. Now, if we go this concept towards this, then we can understand that business analytics is coming in the subset of business intelligence that refers to the use of methodologies such as data mining, predictive analytics, and statistical analysis in order to analyze and transform data into information, then identify and anticipate the trends and outcomes, and ultimately make smarter data-driven business decisions. So obviously we can understand how, with the help of information technology and processing, we are actually processing an information into like knowledge. So first we collect some raw data, we convert it into information, and then we convert it into knowledge. And dear audience, I would request, if you have any queries, do ask on the Google Meet chat box. We'll be answering them accordingly. Like, there is one question is like about the e-certificate. Like, I came to know for the respected organizers that after filling the registration form here in this session, a feedback form will be shared. So if you fill that, then like people might be eligible for the e-certificate. And thanks for joining again. So we see that what are the main components of business analytics? Like it is data aggregation, data mining, association and sequence identification, text mining, forecasting, predictive analytics, optimization, and data visualization. So obviously we can understand that there are various components, and trust me, this list is not exhaustive. The list is, you know, increasing day by day. The need of, you know, business analytics, digital marketing is increasing enormously, because especially because of the COVID-19 pandemic. Things have went online. People are preferring to go on the online mode and do the job. The main criteria of each and every business or organization is profit maximization and loss minimization. So if any strategy is helping them in achieving this objective, they are actually implementing it. Now, what is the connection between this business analytics and digital marketing? Basically, using data to make informed and timely decisions has become a success factor for most modern business and organizations. So at the same time, with the increase in storage and computing capacity and the development of new technologies and applications, such as the expansion of social networks, the widespread use of smartphones, IoT-based devices, the volume and format of the data has changed dramatically. And the possibilities for analyzing and processing it are impressive. So probably due to this abrupt development, there is a lot of confusion and misconceptions about the activities and roles of the different professionals that coexist in the vast ecosystem of the data. So here we can understand that, you know, how vast is the topic, right? And here, if you can see like the business analytics process, we can see how in the form of a simple flowchart, it has been explained. This simple flowchart will actually tell you how you can actually implement the business analytic process and execute the objectives of the organization. First thing what we need to do is discover a business need. Then we need to collect some data, and then we analyze the data, then we predict the outcomes, and then we find the best optimal solution, and then we make a decision. So it is like a loop going on and on. Like, even if we launch a product, like take the example of Apple. Apple has launched some of the best smartphones in today's world. But still, don't you think they continuously upgrade the versions and relaunch it? Why? Because they need to, you know, have a continuous quality improvement mechanism just to make sure that everything is done properly. Okay, and there is some questions coming up. So like about text mining, like we'll be coming to this point, because in the upcoming slides, we have a slide for it actually. So yeah, I think someone has raised their hand. Like, I would request the dear audience to post his or her question on the Google Meet chat box, please. I got a notification that someone raised the hand. Thank you. So here we see the main components of business analytics. Now, before going into it, let's solve this misconception, that one of the most common misconception is there that exists, is to confuse digital marketing and even market research with business intelligent analytics. So these are disciplines that apply different methods and tools to perform their analysis, but above all, with very different objectives. So we can see that the terms Google Analytics and analytics are often used interchangeably by marketers. In fact, they represent two completely different concepts. Perhaps the reason for this confusion is that both Google Analytics and analytics base their analysis on measurable metrics, but this is where the similarities end and the significant distinctions begin. Digital marketing, what is it? It is basically related to ads, you know, through digital channels. And we'll be coming to this slide. And, you know, I would request the audience to have some patience, like all your questions will be answered, I assure you. So to better understand the complex world of the internet and its advertising channels, and thus be able to apply the best formula for success of your product, marketers will need specialized support such as that provided by Google Analytics in order to track website activity. Okay, so obviously you can understand how Google Analytics is important both for business analytics as well as digital marketing. Although they have different objectives, but they come and meet at the same point, that is overall growth and development of the organization or the institution which is applying these strategies. Now we come to the main components, that it's first is data aggregation. So first, you know, before we start with the analysis, data must be gathered, organized and filtered either through volunteer data or transactional records. For example, we take some primary data. We want to launch a new product, learning management system, which will help India, Bangladesh and other Southeast Asian countries to develop. And then they can connect with the Western world and the entire world can come up into a single learning management system. Suppose such plans are there, but how to do it? What are the factors we should include in the learning management system? This all comes into this phase that we should do our survey. We ask the people, we ask the users who are going to use it, that what else do you want in this system? We are providing some like A, B, C, D, five factors. And what else factors do you need? What else uses? What else facilities, amenities do you want in that system? Okay, first thing is this. And second thing is, there is already a learning management system implemented on some country. We ask that country's company and we get that data. We get that secondary data. And then we try to analyze, okay, these were the factors which has been included on the data set. And we are trying to analyze them. And then we build our own sets of constraints or protocols. Then comes the data mining phase. Data mining is very interesting. And one question was that about text mining. I'll be explaining it to you in a very good way just now in few minutes, because it's in this slide only, text mining. So data mining and text mining, very interesting and very excellent algorithms. And important thing, which has actually been one of the main reasons that information technology has become a important thing for management. Okay, so basically you can understand data mining is for business analytics, which sorts through large data sets using databases, statistics and machine learning to identify trends and establish relationships. So obviously you can understand how we can do it. For example, if we take the example of stock market. Okay, someone wants to analyze this data and try to understand what are the least risky shares or which shares should one invest. So you can understand various financial analysts do these things. How they do it? They do it by data mining. They actually get some past data and then analyze them and then try to and get some trends onto it. I will give you a very good example also for take example of Amazon, very good and famous company. Okay, so whenever you will see in YouTube also, everyone watches YouTube, right? So in YouTuber Amazon, you will find that in different accounts, different types of products are coming up in Amazon, different types of videos are coming up on the YouTube account based on the account holder. Okay, I like detective stories. I like science fiction movies. So obviously whenever I open YouTube, those type of videos will come up. Okay, whenever I open Amazon, some detective story book will come up or some things like which I like, electronic devices, that will come up. But if someone is liking any other thing like maybe, you know, sunglasses, cosmetics, then those types of products will come up. So obviously they actually analyze the patterns of your buying behavior and then they try to produce some results in front of it. Now, what is the use of it? People are actually very happy after going to the website. They see, okay, fine. People are actually, you know, receiving it, then analyzing, okay, these are the products and services provided with this website. So obviously it increases the chance of the buying behavior of the person, because something we're getting in front of the screen only. Okay, you go to the shopping mall and whatever product you wanted, it is right in front of you in the shelf. So obviously it's, you know, it increases the probability of buying. So obviously it's a win-win situation for both. You save your time in buying, and the seller actually is selling that product, which was his or her main objective. Okay, then comes association and sequence identification. The identification of predictable actions that are performed in association with other actions, or which is done sequentially. Okay, so basically is trying to associate. Okay, someone is buying a bread, then obviously that person might buy a butter. That's kind of sequence. Then comes a text mining approach, which explores and organizes large unstructured text data sets for the purpose of qualitative and quantitative analysis. Now, obviously, I will try to make you understand with this. Suppose there is a data set. Okay, there are two data set. Okay, you can watch my video also. Like this data set and this data set, we are taking two different data sets and we are trying to, these are like, suppose, for example, we want complete demographic data of India and Bangladesh. Okay, so what we do, we collect the data sets and we analyze and bring something fruitful out of it. How? Like, for example, we trying to analyze that, okay, what we are like, Apple is going to launch a new phone, and what are the prospective buyers in India, Bangladesh, and all the countries around it? And then we will focus, okay, this will be the marketing strategy for this area, this will be the marketing strategy for this area. Now, for example, if we are talking about all the prospective consumers, so you can understand that how much large the data can be. It is a big data. I mean, maybe the population of the country is like, you know, in crores, and you know, we get data of around 2 lakh people. Now, if someone asks, okay, give me some output out of it, you cannot, you know, check, give him him or her the entire data set. You will tell in form of some bar charts, some qualitative or quantitative analysis. Okay, after analyzing 1 lakh respondents, we found that these were the factors people were looking into the mobile, a kind of a 5G network and maybe a better services and some free apps also preloaded, because people, this is a common thing which I've been found from feedbacks of Apple users, that they are already paying so much for the phone, then why to pay for the apps also? So maybe some free services. So these things, how will you get out of it? You will understand after analyzing the 1 lakh people, if even 85,000 people are actually providing this feedback, that come on, Apple should provide free apps and services, then that point will be taken as a, you know, analysis. After analysis, you found that 85% of the people are actually going with this thing. So this is how you can, with the help of text mining, you can do qualitative and quantitative analysis. One more better example is I hope you have heard about natural language processing or sentiment analysis. Okay, some people, what they do in Amazon, you will see, or in any application you use for e-commerce services, they ask for feedbacks. So obviously they ask for feedbacks because a big reason is there. They do sentiment analysis, they run some NLP algorithms to check the sentiments of the users. Are users happy or sad, or they are, you know, having some positive or negative sentiments with that product, or having some neutral sentiments? They want to check it. This all are coming under the text mining phase. Then comes the forecasting method. Like, I hope I answered the question as asked in the chat box. If any more questions, then please do feel free to ask. Okay, then is forecasting. So what is forecasting? It's analyzing the historical data from a specific period in order to make informed estimates that are predictive in determining future events or behaviors. So obviously we can understand that how it is important. Again, after collecting the data, we are trying to predict or forecast something. Then obviously that's the need of the hour. If some company, you know, devises a machine learning algorithm or an AI based algorithm and tells that, okay, from tomorrow, this product will get in huge demand from this area A, but will have a fall in demand in area B. Then understand how much the company can save. What they will do, they will decrease the supply from area B and increase the supply in area A. So they are, you know, getting the strategies from before, because they are actually finding the problems from before. So they are actually formulating remedial strategies in time and implementing it. Then is predictive analytics. Predictive business analytics uses a variety of statistical techniques to create predictive models. Like, for example, you might have heard about some machine learning algorithms like LSTM, SVM, that is long short-term memory support vector machine, then RF, that is random forest algorithms. So some algorithms actually create predictive models like simple regressive moving average or even simple regression also. Okay, so with these extract information from data sets, then identify the patterns and then provide a predictive score for an array of organizational outcomes. For example, a company, a tourism company is there. So obviously they take the help of, various algorithms to understand which area is based on which season. Like people, when the people has a huge rush in area A or area B or area C. Based on that, the tourism companies actually strategically plan their tours. Okay, so if someone can predict this thing, someone has actually the data of from 2005 to 2020, and take the example of COVID also pandemic. Suppose 2019 till 2019 there is a data set, and then 2020-21. So obviously, with the help of this analytics, they can actually predict. Okay, in year 2022. This will be the areas tourists will visit in this time. Okay, so from before only, the people knows, the owner of the tour and travel company knows that this place has to be targeted in this month. So they will strategically improve their organizational outcome. Then is optimization. Once trends have been identified and predictions have been made, businesses can engage simulation techniques to test out best case scenarios and optimize strategies. For example, I'll tell you the example. You might have seen simulation techniques on, like I love watching Discovery and National Geography. You will see when people learn driving an aeroplane, they're not given an aeroplane from first, because obviously it's costly. Someone, just crashes it, then it's gone. Like it's, a loss of crores. So some simulation models have been made. Like people are made to sit on that aircraft simulation model. And then they are taught how to drive a plane. Then when they are learning it, after that, they will go to the real scenario. Now just take the simple example of a business who wants to launch a product, a very big and costly product. Okay. Now suppose they have started production and produced thousands of, products, and then they launched in the market. Then obviously if the people likes it, very good. But if they don't like it, then what happens? It's a loss of crores now. So to avoid this loss and ensure profits, what is done? Some pilot studies are done. Some simulation techniques are applied just to check the product and service and its feedback from the consumers or a set of sampling frame. Okay. Then they optimize it, check the best case scenarios, and then finally launch the product or service in the market. Excuse me. Then we see about data visualization. So basically, data visualization provides visual representations such as bars, charts, graphs, etc. for quick and easy data analysis. For example, you want to check how many males and females are happy with Apple phones, how many men and women are happy with Samsung phones or any other company phones. What will you do? You will draw a pie chart, then try to, provide a percentage. Okay, this was the percentage of men, women, and transgender who love or liked the product or service. So this will help you in a visual representation, which is actually helping in easy and quick data analysis. Now we jump to a new topic, that is introduction to digital marketing. Now, any marketing that uses electronic devices to convey promotional messaging and measure its impact can be called as digital marketing. So I hope you have understood with the definition. What is the scope of digital marketing? It's very big. Because nowadays you will see all types of publicity and marketing are using electronic devices. And example I'll give you is, you know, take the example of this webinar. Even we used digital marketing techniques for getting such huge participation. Like the respected organizers posted our webinar details on Facebook, WhatsApp, LinkedIn, Twitter, everywhere, Instagram. And thanks a lot to the coordinators for this. So this is actually a real life example of digital marketing. So in practice, digital marketing typically refers to marketing campaigns that appear on a computer, phone, tablet, or other device. And nowadays, these things are very common. Everyone has a phone or a computer because it's the need of the hour. It can take many forms, including online video, display ads, and social media posts. So digital marketing is often compared to traditional marketing, such as magazine ads, billboards, and direct emails. So oddly, television is usually lumped in with traditional marketing because it was like started from before, so it's a primitive way, that's why. So optimize your marketing strategies. Digital is mandatory. So digital, you know, getting digitalized, you know, digital economy. I hope you have heard about all these things. Like nowadays, you do online payments, right? Previously, you never thought to pay someone online, right? You always thought, okay, we should bring some cash and then pay, right? So digital marketing can help you get your audience, learn the important data about them, and provide metrics that will give you marketing team credibility. It will increase the effectivity, the efficiency of the marketing team. It will analyze the customers and then provide some better marketing plan to generate products and services in a better way, along with higher revenues. Okay, I found some audience were raising hands. So if you have any questions, I just repeat that. Please post on the chat box. I'll be answering. Then is digital marketing, which is also called as online marketing. It is the promotion of brands to connect with potential consumers or customers using the internet and other forms of digital communication. So obviously you can understand, whatever is going with the help of digital medium, any kind of marketing or publicity, that can be called as digital marketing. And obviously this does not only includes email, social media, or web-based advertising. It also contains the text or the multimedia messages. Like for example, you will find various messages which are coming as texts in your mobile. Those mediums are also digital marketing. So essentially, any marketing campaign involves digital communication that can be called as digital marketing. So there are various types of digital marketing, which are like SEO, search engine optimization, content marketing, social media marketing, pay-per-click marketing, affiliate marketing, native advertising, marketing automation, and email marketing. Let's discuss about search engine optimization. So obviously it's very important. You might have heard that some websites are performing very good. Some websites are not doing that well. So what plays in behind? That is the quality of the content, the level of the user engagement, the mobile friendliness, and the number and quality of the inbound links. These are some important elements to optimize a web page. Okay, for example, I'll tell you, there is a conference, a very good IEEE conference, but they have not implemented SEO into them. And there is a mediocre IEEE conference, but they have good SEO built in their website, SEO algorithms. Do you know the moderate conference will be doing better because people will be knowing about it? Huh? Someone is searching with some keywords like IEEE conference in November 2021. Now, these keywords, if they are fitted into the algorithm of the SEO of that website, then obviously that website will come up. So people normally in Google also, you have seen after with various research studies and pattern analysis of the users, it has been seen that normally after searching a thing in a Google page, people don't go after the fourth to fifth page. Okay, so obviously SEO helps in getting the website upwards in that search engine. Okay, that's why it is called as search engine optimization. That is the name itself suggests that optimizing the search engine. Okay, this is how it works. So using various factors are very important here. So in SEO, there's no quantifiable rubric or consistent rule for ranking highly. Google changes its algorithm almost constantly, so it is impossible to make exact predictions. So what we can do is, with the help of Google Analytics, we can just monitor the page performance and find, okay, these were the keywords which are being searched by users, and these were the keywords related to the website. So accordingly, the algorithm should be built so that search engine optimization is implemented. Then is content marketing. Now, obviously, all these types are closely related and they help in proper marketing techniques. Search engine optimization is a major factor in content marketing because contents are very important. Catchy contents, good contents, you know, brief, precise, so that people will read it and find, okay, these are the takeaways from the product or service. And just try to make a content in such a way that is actually motivates or inspires the customers to avail that product or service. Okay, so what is content marketing? It is a strategy based on the distribution of relevant and valuable content to the target audience. Okay, for example, someone is a vegetarian. So obviously you should, you know, publicize veg food in front of that person. If someone is non-vegetarian, then obviously the marketeers or the sellers should broadcast non-vegetarian foods in front of that person. So, and which catchy contents with good photos, okay, a food, like, you know, nowadays we'll find most of the restaurants have good posters in front of them with good dishes so that people get inspired to go to that restaurant. Okay, so as in any marketing strategy, the goal of content marketing is to attract leads that ultimately convert into customers, but it does so differently than traditional advertising. Instead of enticing prospects with potential value from a product or service, so it basically offers for free in the form of written material. So basically, how you can understand that the goal of good content is to attract customers. That's it. As simple as that. Any content which catches the attention of the customers, that's done. That's good. That's awesome. So it has been seen with on various statistics, and rest assured, my all my statistics or data has been properly referenced, and at the end of the presentation, the references are also has been provided, and they are taken from trusted sources. So it has been seen that 84% of consumers expect companies to produce entertaining and helpful content experiences. It has been also found that 60% of companies have at least 5,000 employees which actually are producing contents daily. And 92% of marketers believe that their company's values content is a very important asset. So you can understand how good contents can actually help in search engine optimization. Good content marketing can help in generating more sales and revenues for the company. Okay, there is a question here in the Google Meet chat box. Hey, can you just be precise with your question, please? Because I'm in this section, so obviously I can answer your question right now only. Are you asking about the latent semantic indexing keywords? So basically, the question is like about LSI keywords. Obviously, they are very important because they are actually helping to understand the context of the target audience. Okay, so basically, everything has classifications. So LSI means latent semantic indexing keywords. So basically, these are the keywords which are actually search engines use to understand the content on the web page and what is the context of the target audience. So basically, there are various LSI keywords, which can be used to improve your content. Like, for example, I'll tell you in simple language, we use hashtags nowadays in social media posts because, whenever hashtag has been put on a post, then obviously with that help of hashtag, it increases the potentiality of that post. The potential increases and the reach increases. Okay, there is another question, whether this both domain can be worked one person or any vacancy available for roadmap is there. Like, can you just be clear with your question? Okay. Like, as per I understand, like, you know, it's asking about the domains maybe. So yeah, business analytics and digital marketing are like important domains, and obviously lots of jobs are there in this area. Plenty of jobs, because these are the trending areas which people are working on. So I hope everyone's question I have answered, you know, successfully. If any other queries are there, please do feel free to ask in the Google Meet chat box. And organizers are like, I would like to request, like, I have some time to complete my presentation, right? Or shall I rush with within and complete within 9:30? I just try to. Yeah.
You can take your time.
Okay, like, may I know how much time do I have to complete the presentation so that I can complete it in time?
We can give you 30 minutes. We can post it.
Sure. That's more than enough. Thank you so much. Thank you. Okay. Yeah. So we see here about social media marketing. Okay. It means driving traffic and brand awareness by engaging people in a discussion online. Okay. Very important part. Social media is considered nowadays to be one of the best effective way of digital marketing. And it has also witnessed various growths in it. All the social media platforms have witnessed that all the businesses, all the organizations, all the educational institutions are opening their pages in social media websites, because everywhere it has been seen that it is one of the most economical ways of marketing, along with huge generations of revenues, because the reach is very big. In social media, most popular platforms for social media marketing is Facebook, Twitter, WhatsApp, Instagram, LinkedIn, and YouTube. So social media marketing involves active audience participation. It has also become a popular way of getting attention. So it is gaining around in the business to business sphere as well. Business to business, I'll tell you. For example, if a company is taking a help from a company, or he's collaborating with a company for something, like, for example, good car manufacturing companies have B2B relations with MRF tires, you know, MRF. So basically, if a car manufacturing company is taking a tire from a different company, then obviously we can tell that they have business to business collaboration. Okay. So according to the Content Marketing Institute, 61% of B2B content marketers increased their social media usage recently. Okay. Social media marketing is actually offering various engagement metrics, which are already built into them. So which are extremely useful in helping you to understand how well you are reaching your audience. So you get to decide which types of interactions means the most to you, and whether that means the number of shares, comments, or total clicks to your websites are, obviously these are some metrics, useful metrics, how the post is gaining. Obviously in your personal accounts also, you nowadays see, no? Okay, this post is getting this much likes, people are commenting on it, this is the engagement of the post. So obviously these are very important metrics in the case of businesses also. Whenever there is a organizational page, you will find that they actually do some marketing to enhance their visibility, do publicity, and increase the number of likes, reach, comments, shares. Obviously, mostly find in good YouTube videos also. In YouTube videos, at the last, there is obviously a last, you know, a common disclaimer found, like, okay, like and subscribe this video, because obviously it's a win-win situation for both. The person who is watching the video is also getting entertained, and the, you know, the person who is actually making the video, with the help of this like, shares, and viewing time, that person is also having growth. So direct purchases may not even be a goal of your social media marketing strategy. So you can understand that social media marketing is a bigger domain. It has huge targets, and they can do marketing in any way. Okay, suppose in one post also, two, three marketings can be done, like two, three companies marketing can be done. For example, someone is doing a conference which has been funded or sponsored by IEEE, ACM, everyone. Okay. So obviously if we use tags like hashtag IEEE, hashtag ACM, and then we, with the help of @, we, you know, tag those bodies also, IEEE, or ACM. These are big, you know, organizations. So we can, with this help, we can actually do a social media marketing strategy, which will increase the prospects of the product or the service. In this case, it's a service, obviously, educational service, that is conference. So many brands use social media marketing to start dialogues with audiences rather than encourage them to spend money right away. Obviously, this is the worst part, because you will find some chat box, you will find AI bots also. Is my voice audible clearly?
Yes, sir.
Yes, it is clear.
Okay, I just asked because someone posted on the chat box that there were some issues. Anyways, thank you for such a good and patient audience. So many brands use social media marketing, you know, to start dialogues. You will find various, you know, chat box in the Facebook also, or in any company, you will find they are using AI bots. What they're doing is, here also the text mining part is coming into play. It was really a very important point. Thanks for the question also, because such good questions actually enhance the, you know, experience of the webinar. Because, you know, what I feel is teaching, learning and discussions, these are like should be together, because a teacher also keeps learning, a student also keeps teaching, and they should discuss with each other. And, you know, it's a good thing, because after all, a teacher is always teaching. And a student is always learning. But if such interactive platforms are produced, then obviously it's great. Even these webinars, I mean, these webinars, conferences, they are all using social media marketing strategy. Nowadays, it is so important. So many brands use this, obviously, for discussions with the help of chatbots. AI-based chatbots means, like, if a question is posted, then they just, you know, analyze that question and then answer accordingly. And I mean, the machine learning algorithm is answering the question based on the codes coded by a human being. Okay, this is the beauty of, you know, information technology, that human beings code something in a form of an algorithm, program runs it, and then the system gets automated. This is especially common in brands that target older audiences or offer products and services not appropriate for impulse buying. Okay, suppose, you know, some adult people, they will, before they see our advertisement, they will feel, okay, come on, they are advertising it because they want to sell it. But some social media marketing strategies work in such a way that they first, you know, motivate the consumers to get into the propaganda by doing some quizzes or coupons. And then the final target product or service has been sold. Then we go to pay-per-click marketing. I'll bit rush with the presentation because, you know, I have to cover the entire part within time. So if any questions, I say again, please do ask on the Google Meet chat box. And dear organizers, like some participants are asking about the feedback form. Yeah. So what that is pay-per-click marketing. Okay. So it is a platform and it ensures that people are clicking on it and they're keeping a track of it. Okay, you will understand various websites have a, you know, counter also in below the web page, that how many people have visited that website. Okay, so obviously based on that, the algorithm prioritizes each available ad based on a number of factors, which is like ad quality, keyword relevance, landing page quality, bid amount. For example, take the example of Google Ads or any other website. You know, Facebook also. Facebook is generating a huge revenue from such ads. Okay, so some person is having accounts on various, you know, movie websites or movie pages. Then advertisement of new movies will come up in that social media account. Someone is having, you know, favoritism towards electronics. Okay, the electronic devices are his or her favorite products. Then such products will come up, such ads will come up. And if someone clicks on that, then it's kind of pay-per-click marketing. Someone is clicking on that. But if someone is clicking on it and doing some transactional or non-transactional work, but if anyone clicks on it also, then also a lead gets generated. Okay, that's why. So whatever you choose as your target conversions, you can track them via your chosen platform to see how your campaign is doing. For example, you made an ad, posted it on a social media platform, 10 people are clicking on it, and another ad, you see 100 people are clicking on it, then obviously the second one is much better. Then is affiliate marketing. You might have heard about, you know, like things like companies like Oriflame or any other company. These are very famous companies. Okay, Amway. Okay, they do affiliate marketing. What they do? They make some products and then ensure that people sell it through a distributor network. That is affiliated marketing. Okay, so basically, producer is someone else. They are taking the help of, you know, retailers or affiliate marketers, and they are selling it on the behalf of the company. Okay, so they use various digital marketing techniques also, like WhatsApp groups. Nowadays, you have seen in COVID pandemic, such companies have started Zoom sessions also. So this is also part. Then is native advertising. Native advertising is marketing in disguise. Okay, it's another ambush marketing. Its goal is to blend in with its surrounding content so that it is less blatantly obvious as advertising. Okay, for example, I'll tell you, someone wants to advertise about a college. Okay, so that person goes to a tea shop, and there another person is talking about, okay, today we had an admission in this college, XYZ college, but we couldn't get admitted. So let's try some other college. Then that person who is actually listening to this starts publicizing about an ABC college. Okay, this college has good admission percentages. They allow all students to join based on various, you know, constraints. So this is a kind of advertisement which is on a needs basis. Okay, that person was actually going to promote the college, but he or she started promoting it when the person started talking about another college. Okay, needs basis advertising, and it is native advertising. You just show it in such a way that people don't think that you are advertising. Now take this example on a digital atmosphere. Okay, some contents you will see promoted or sponsored contents. They have some indicators. So when your consumers know exactly what they are getting, they'll feel better about your content and your brand. So native ads are meant to be less obtrusive than traditional ads, but they are not meant to be deceptive. The reason why I'm saying this is the native advertising is like kind of someone, example of, NetMeds or PharmEasy. Okay, if someone needs a medicine, these companies come up, provides that medicine. Okay, now someone is not asking to take medicine if someone doesn't even want. Okay, but these apps are so beautifully designed. They analyze the patterns of the users and they promote in such a way that it seems that it is very, you know, normal, and they are actually trying to help you rather than making an ad. Okay, then is marketing automation. And respected audience, our honorable organizers have already shared the feedback form. You can fill it as needed. Then is marketing automation. Marketing automation actually uses software to power digital marketing campaigns, improve the efficiency and relevance of advertising. So marketing automation actually lets the company keep up with the expectation of personalization. For example, it allows brands to collect and analyze consumer information, design target marketing campaigns, and send and post marketing messages at the right time to the right audience. Example, take the already explained Amazon, Flipkart, Alibaba. Okay, any company, any e-commerce website you will go, you will find they are always analyzing your orders. And do you know, they also analyze the products you are searching but not ordering. So they are actually analyzing your entire pattern. Even in videos, take the best case. Anyone can check it. Take five accounts, different accounts of YouTube. Whenever you go to the page, that first five different accounts will have five different types of videos in their front screen, because that is based on those accounts' usage. Okay, someone is liking some comedy videos. Someone is writing romantic videos. Someone is watching detective videos. So based on that, the videos will come up on the screen. So how they're doing it? They're actually collecting and continuously analyzing the information, because their target is what? The people should visit their website, spend more time in that website. It will become an interactive campaign, and the marketing campaign should actually, post the correct message in the right time to the right audience. Someone wants to check some breaking news. Instantly, that breaking news should come up. This is how the patterns is analyzed and the consumer's experience are improved. So many marketing automation tools are using prospect managed engagement with a particular message to determine when and how to reach out next. Okay, they're analyzing with the help of this real-time customization, which means that you can effectively create an individualized marketing strategy for each customer without any additional time. How? Suppose the variables are type of videos, gender, age, various types of variables have been taken. Okay, the algorithm is XYZ, but the data sets has various percent into these variables. Like take the example of a table. There are various columns with various fields. Now, obviously, a person named XYZ is male and he watches directive videos. A person named ABC is a female and she watches comedy videos. So obviously we understand that those person are actually in that list of database. Algorithm is one single algorithm. With that help, they are running that entire analysis without any additional time. Now, just, you know, they're just doing the programming. It's the beauty of digital marketing. Then is email marketing. The concept of email marketing is very simple. Okay, some important points which I should tell you is that any email should have contents which are individualized both in the body and the subject line. Like for example, if you write dear all, in that place there are some automation tools which automatically in IEEE emails you will find this facility. Like dear, then the name ABC XYZ automatically gets updated based on the email ID and the data. Okay, then it clearly states there is a subscriber option. And if someone does not want to receive those emails, they can select the unsubscribe option also. This should be provided because it increases the visibility as well as the acceptability of the email. Then it integrates both transactional and promotional emails as well. And it has been found that it is one of the most effective lead generator in digital marketing domains. Even today's respected and prestigious webinar was also circulated with the help of emails. So you can understand how emails are very important. So it can be even better if you incorporate other techniques such as marketing automation, which can actually help you in segmenting and schedule your emails so that they meet your customer needs more effectively. So obviously, what are the benefits of business analytics is that there are more kind of revenue is being generated, more profits, more informed decision making, and it also helps in improving the operational efficiency. Through learning how to recognize trends, test hypotheses, and draw conclusions from population samples, actually you can help in building an analytical framework that can be applied in your everyday decision making and help your organization thrive. For example, there is a project management app which is actually providing the organization with all the analysis related to their business on the basis of that single project or different projects on different tabs. Okay, so with that help, actually you can understand anyone can be benefited even from work from home also. Nowadays in the COVID pandemic, you will see that most of the people are doing work from home. So obviously there should be a common management information system which is actually controlling the entire business analytics scenario with the help of various database administrators, various coders, programmers, developers, as well as the human resource of that company. So there is a saying that if you don't use the data, you are going to fall behind, said by Hammond, an honorable person. And people that have those capabilities as well as an understanding of business context are going to be the ones that will add the most value and have the greatest impact. Then there are some benefits of digital marketing as well. It obviously has a broader geographic reach. Come on, someone says you to cover the entire area of your city in one day, you cannot do it physically. But do you know you can do it digitally? Just do one thing. Just extract all the data related to that emails of that city, the social media platforms used by the users of that city based on the location analysis, and then just post the content with proper search engine optimization techniques that will reach everywhere. Okay, then is cost efficiency. Then is obviously it's cost efficient because it's saving lots of money. Everyone knows this very well. That even you take the example of availing a digital product or service, like you want to avail any product online, you don't have to go, you don't have to, you know, take out any vehicle, no petrol, diesel investment, just sit on the room, order a product, it comes to your room. That also in a discount sometimes, because Amazon or websites like Flipkart or other websites, Alibaba, they provide lots of discounts. There is quantifiable results. They provide complete quantitative analysis. That is the beauty of digital marketing. Like in other, most of the, you know, marketing channels, you have to do a proper survey, then you can get some results. But in digital marketing, the algorithm is already statistically analyzed. So they will provide a ready-made quantifiable result. And you can see, suppose there are 4 marketing strategies, which one is performing better, which is performing good, which is not good, which should be upgraded. That's it. That is easier personalization. You can personalize your marketing strategy based on the customer. That also with few lines of codes. There is more connection with customers. Obviously, the reach is more. Then is easy and convenient conversions. You can take feedbacks instantly in the online medium, because you don't have to even call also. You can just provide a feedback form. They will people will, you know, like it, provide their feedback, and that's done. And even here also, you can see a real-time example. Feedback form has been provided just to, you know, get feedbacks of our prestigious webinar. Then is digital marketing actually helps in creating growth. Digital marketing also should be one of the most primary focuses of almost any business overall marketing strategy. So it has been seen that never before there has been a way to stay in such a consistent contact with customers, but digitalized medium has done this. Technology, IT infrastructure has provided a new normal from where a computer can actually, you know, with the help of the user and the computer, the entire digital marketing and business analytics atmosphere can be controlled. So the more you embrace the possibilities of digital marketing, the more you will be able to realize your company's growth potential. Thank you so much. And thank you so much for your patient hearing. And I would just like to share one slide. This is my slide only from SlideShare. It talks about a social media marketing strategy of our college. And you can just read it whenever you have time. And I'm sorry, like I crossed the time. That's why I'm just planning to complete my presentation now. So thank you so much. Thank you, everyone.
Sir, is there any questions that is not replied by you in the chat box?
No, all the questions have been answered.
Okay.
Yeah, like, and will you mind if I just, you know, share my another slide just for a few minutes, just to, you know, provide a brief idea at what I was talking about. Like I would be taking not more than two, three minutes. Can I?
Yes, sure.
Yeah. So this is a PPT which I've already provided in the Google Meet chat box. It's in SlideShare. This was a real-time example of how we can implement social media marketing for our management department. So this is an initiative which we did. We used various strategies like relationship strategy, product service strategy, customer strategy, price strategy. And this was the social media strategy which we used, like, you know, already discussed Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, where we used live video services, proactive campaigns, content marketing. You know, this is like, you know, a true case study which you can take help of to understand how digital marketing is so important. Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much. And I'm really obliged with the organizers for their great organizational capabilities, and they have coordinated the webinar in very good way. An excellent way, rather. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker Sarthak Sengupta, for your enlightening presentation. We are impressed having a great seminar. I think the participants learned a lot today and will be much benefited by the webinar.
Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you.
Now, I'd like to request to present the crest of appreciation for our honorable speaker.
Thank you so much, sir.
Sir, please accept this appreciation.
Thank you so much. It's really awesome. And I'm really obliged. I mean, thank you so much.
Nice to meet you.
And this initiative is so good. I mean, it saved pages, you know, it's a green initiative rather, you know, and so good. Yes, ma'am.
At this time, I'd like to ask Prosenjit Roy Pappu, Chair of IEEE Censors Council, BUBT Student Branch Chapter, to express his opinion about today's event.
Thank you, Raymond.
Prosenjit Roy Pappu.
I'm audible?
Yes.
So first of all, thanks our honorable speaker, Mr. Sarthak Shengupta, and to make this webinar such a very, very instructive. And we are very mobilized, and thanks all participation who are attend this webinar. Thanks a
thank
lot.
Thank you so much.
Thank
sir.
You
so much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
It's really an honor. Yeah. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Prosenjit Roy Pappu. Thank you once again to all the honorable guests, faculty members, and students for your cooperations. That is a must for all time. It's been a pleasure being with all of you today, and again, thanks you all for your great patience. However, we have reached to the ending moment of our webinar. I wish your participation is our next event. So stay safe and sound. Good night.
Thank you and good night, everyone.